Can this market, can the PSEi afford incoming President Marcos a honeymoon period? 100 days of just boom, boom, boom.
All right, let's look at the traditional definition of a political honeymoon period. That is a period, and why the first 100 days from the U.S. is because that was the time that an incoming president had lots of political capital and could push for his legislative program. Look, legislators are not going to go against the wishes of the public, even in the Philippines. If the, as what you mentioned earlier, that public enthusiasm for federalism is just not there. And to push for federalism against the wishes of the public is not going to be successful. So that honeymoon period doesn't have to do with the stock market. It has to do with the amount of political capital, the high approval ratings that a president has. And if you want to talk about a honeymoon period based on that definition, then I guess Duterte had a six-year honeymoon period because he had very high, very strong political capital for the first 6 years. Now, granted, as I said last Tuesday, Marcos will take the lead in the Philippines of a situation, an international and domestic situation that's never existed before. Mm-hmm. So right now, all bets are off in terms of making a comparison between a presidential inauguration and turnover today going back 20 years. It is an incredibly difficult time, as you pointed out. We've got inflation, we've got oil prices, we've got all kinds of weird things going on. And I don't know, I'm certainly glad that I'm not the president of this or any other country.
All right.
Will there be a honeymoon period in terms of the stock market? I don't think so. I think there's going to be, we're going to continue on and look at the economy and what it's doing on a day-to-day, week-to-week basis.
A final question, though, John. Simply put, as an investor, as a businessman, what do you need from the next government?
Well, it's like I said, we need investment. And foreign investment is wonderful, but that's not where the money is. The money is right here in the Philippines. We need Filipino companies investing in the Philippines. We need Filipino companies. We need to increase our gross fixed capital expenditure and formation. That's only going to come from Filipino companies. And they are not going to start investing until they see that the consumer is out there buying. Now, what I'm noticing, and I'm a mall rat, all right? I might as well be 18 years old because that's where I spend all my time. What I'm seeing is people are getting out, they're buying, but they're not buying in the numbers that they were before. And there's several reasons for that. If you go to the supermarkets, they're half empty or all empty because people are shopping from home online. And that is a trend that is going to continue. And but people are, if you go to the malls, what are people doing? They're going to the movies, they're eating in restaurants, and they're kind of nosing around when it comes to their shopping. And that has got to improve. And it will improve over time as long as we avoid any kind of a lockdown. As far as the stock market goes, the stock market varies between being a leading economic indicator and a trailing economic indicator. And either way, it's about 3 to 6 months in any direction. Now, what I'm seeing the stock market doing right now in general is perhaps lagging the economy in that consumer sentiment is positive. The stock market is not positive yet. And I think what the stock market is doing is reflecting more of what happened in the previous 6 months of 2022 versus what happened in the what's going to happen in the following months of 2022.
All right. On that note, thank you very much, John, for joining us this morning. Always a pleasure speaking with you.
Thank you, Michelle.